top 10 private bee schools in India.
Our focus is on cutting edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businessmen.
Big Tech, excellence with values.
Thinking about changes, but implementation seems a big question mark. There are some specific issues which Mr. Tiswas Subramaniam raised. I think they will be covered in the course of various speakers' speeches. But what is very crucial is that are we going to respect rule of law in this country or not? If rule of law is to be respected, the parliamentarian, he cannot take a chapel and beat somebody else. He has to know that there is a consequence for that. Parliamentarians should know that they have to be role models in ensuring there is respect for rule of law or respect for law. So I do hope that in the course of our deliberations, we will certainly focus on some of these urgent issues. Mr. C.S.R. Bruni mentioned about CBI, IT and Enforcement Directorate should be within the purview of the Election Commission. I only hope that can be done, because I'm sure if that kind of an activity comes in the purview of the Election Commission, which of course to some extent they did it in R.K. Nagar recently, but there will be a revolt in this country as if the Election Commission is running the country, democracy. There is an utter contempt for politicians in this country, but at the same time there is a lot of expectations of the Election Commission to bring about changes. As both of them pointed out, there is inadequacy of law in this matter. And if you are going to ask the vested interest to bring about these changes, they are not going to bring about unless and until there is a movement, there is a revolt against the present system. And I do hope today's meeting is only a first step in this direction. There is an urgent need to look at the whole thing. And I do hope that the government and the politicians listen to the need of the hour. Thank you very much. The list. I know in a country like India it's not easy to implement. At least certain percentage, maybe 10% or 20% of parliament. Because it will bring about some kind of a national outlook. And this national outlook can come only if you have national leaders in the parliament. We have seen how parliament functioned in early 50s and 60s and how they are functioning now. Members of the parliament talk about not merely for their constituency, they talk about the specific problem in that district or in that town. That's not the way parliament is expected to function. So the first past post system should go. An alternative has to be found. The first past post system also has resulted in proliferation of political parties. Because in a constituency, there's a particular community which is dominant. Each party puts up a leader of that particular community. With the result, the person who is voted to power comes to power with only 20 to 25% of the votes, and he claims himself to be representative of the people of that constituency. But I am reminded of what Edmund Burke said to the voters of one of the constituencies. He said, "Please elect such leaders who are representing your constituency's interest, but when there is a conflict between national interest and the constituency interest, please vote for the one who will vote for the national interest." So unfortunately, at the recruitment stage itself, as many of the speakers mentioned, we have candidates who don't deserve to represent the people, and they come into position because they think that they can harness the votes of a majority of the community to which the constituency is indominant. So second is the first part system should go. The third suggestion I have is about decentralization of powers. Mr. Jayaprakash Narayan also mentioned it. I think people have to come to Delhi for even small things to be approved. They have to come to the state government for certain things to be approved. And the famous amendment to the Panchayat Raj, etc. I think it has been brief, it has been verbose, but no specific purpose has been achieved. There is more corruption in Delhi more corruption in the state capitals only because powers are concentrated. So we must find method that the powers are distributed. It is not that it will do away with corruption at the municipal level or the panchayat level, but at least the scale will come down, and I think people will know not how to vote and how, why they should not vote for a person. But at the moment, such ignorance, I mean such knowledge of the vote candidate is not there. And we vote for a person who turns out to be terribly incompetent. The recall of politicians, recall of the representatives, okay, or no, here again it's a controversial suggestion. I know that there are difficulties in a country like this to implement that. But if you can have a power of recall, at least some misdemeanor people will be afraid of. Could I have a suggestion that first 2.5 years there cannot be a recall of representatives, the half the term of the House should have gone. Thereafter there should be a possibility of a recall, a threat of a recall, not that you'll be able to recall a person with all those conditions attached, but a threat of a recall of misdemeanor by a politician may improve. I mean, that's only a pious wish, may improve the quality of our representatives and their performance in the Legislative Assembly of Parliament. The next area relates to the state elections. I mean, by the local body elections. Unfortunately, the Constitution has delegated this power of appointing a state election commission to the state government. And this law relating to the state election commission varies from state to state. And I don't know whether I can simplify and say that it's a den of corruption. But I must say that the appointments are questionable in most of the state election commissions.